are sights and sounds throughout this city, but for the next few hours, all eyes are glued to Allegiant Stadium here in Las Vegas. Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Las Vegas Raiders. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. For Charles, September is here. The 2023 season just about to get started. So many storylines to pay attention to. What are you most keeping an eye on as the start of the season moves closer?
Martin, I'm glad you asked, because we're going to start, obviously, Aaron Rodgers and the Jets. That's a huge story. How about Kansas City?
Could they win their third title in 5 years? We know some teams are trying to get there. Buffalo, Cincinnati, Philadelphia, San Francisco, all should contend. And how about some of those sleeper teams? I think the Chargers of Pittsburgh in the AFC, Carolina, Detroit in the NFC. It's going to be an exciting season.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Raiders offense heading out with their new man under center for 2023, the former Patriot, former 49er, Jimmy Garoppolo.
It was another typical season for Jimmy G last year. He was out there. He was excellent, leading the 49ers to 7 wins and throwing 4 times as many touchdowns as interceptions. Then the injury bug bit again. But Las Vegas, they're counting on him being able to do the exact same thing they saw in San Francisco, but avoiding injury while doing so.
Now the NFL's leading rusher a season ago, Josh Jacobs.
And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. Man open is Keelan Cole, complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. 22 yards there, a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Nice job there forcing that incompletion. This is going to be a fun battle throughout this game, watching him try to take away that area of the field.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Looking to throw, Garoppolo.
A short throw, and that's hauled in by Mayer.
That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4-down territory, though, if they're stopped. Well, they needed 2. They could only get 1. 4th down.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on 4th and 1. Let's see what they decide to do.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. They go with Jacobs. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose.
Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it.
So they tried it. Not only did they not get the first, they fumbled it away.
Yeah, it's one of those things where it went from bad to worse, but I know that everyone's going to pile in on the call and say, well, what are you doing? Why would you go for it there? I think that teams that are convinced that they feel pretty good about their game plan, what they want to get done that day, go for it. Give it a try. Hey, let's see if your defense can rescue them a little bit.
The Steelers offense set for their first possession here, and it's Kenny Pickett who will lead the way, the second-year man, Charles, from Pitt.
Pickett didn't quite lead Pittsburgh to the promised land in his first season as the hometown kid and franchise quarterback, but he did impress once he got on the field. Winning 7 games helped keep the vaunted streak of non-losing seasons alive in the Steel City.
Now the third-year man, Najee Harris, and he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. 2nd down coming up.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run,
But for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And I think he was a little surprised to see the ball sitting out there like that. That's a ball he had a chance to come away with, but it winds up an incomplete pass.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Divine Diablo. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
Boy, he had to fit that into a pretty tight window over the middle. And, Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes just fooled by the type of zone that he sees. Because oftentimes those linebackers will vacate and run downfield with receivers. In this case, he played a pure zone and was in the wrong spot for the QB.
So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. And his throw here's incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up 2nd and 10. Running straight ahead is Jacobs. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Now an injury timeout. And that is Davante Adams, who is in some discomfort following that play. We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. They show run with 3 tight ends here on 1st down. To throw is Garoppolo. Take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. So they get their tight end away from the line to the outside, and he works his way in for 6.
Tight ends are not just blockers anymore. I don't know how many more times we need examples, but here's a great one. Gets to the outside, they give him the ball pretty quickly, and they trust him to get those extra yards, and boy, did he come through bullying his way into the end zone after the nice catch.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Olszewski going to hold on to this one. Touchback. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their 2nd offensive possession. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number 2?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
A nice carry by Harris, who had tougher sledding than in his Pro Bowl rookie season, but still topped 1,000 yards as a Steeler sophomore. As Pittsburgh tries to climb back to the top of the AFC North, he remains a player that their offense relies on.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it'll be 2nd and very short.
Now, that was an excellent run, and when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job, and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block, but the wide receivers, all they want to do.
There he goes, left side, and he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
58 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. Now here's another carry for Harris. Marcus Epps there on the tackle.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. When we call them run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Second and seven. Looking to throw, Pickett. Slant route, and he's got fire move. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards.
And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Jalen Warren. It's a one-yard touchdown run, and the Steelers are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. Three tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in.
And you saw where that one went, right? You run it over your best blocker. I can just see the head coach right now. I want to run this one over the big boy. And they got it done.
Extra point put through by Boswell, and we are tied at seven. So this drive spans seven plays, and it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. No return here for Carter, and this will be a touchback. The Raiders offense ready to go. And Garoppolo going to lead the Raiders up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now a first carry for Brandon Bolden. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Garoppolo looks to throw. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First catch of the game for Adams. He's got a first down. Seven, our score after one. Second quarter from Vegas, the homestanding Raiders with a football here as they've got it with a first and 10. A handoff, Jacobs running to the left. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Garoppolo being chased out left and to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
And he is caught, and they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 40. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up the first down.
Over the middle, complete. It's Cole.
And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And it's complete to Adams. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field. And just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Here's Jacobs. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Josh Jacobs, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders have taken the lead.
So, partner, it was a passing game that drove them down the field, but when they get close, they trust that man in the backfield, and he took them home.
And they trust their offensive line as well, because so many of these units, they specialize in either pass protection or run blocking. This group shows its versatility and gets both done on this drive.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good, and that makes the score 14-7. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Najee Harris and the rest of this offense work their way back onto the field.
And I'm wondering if maybe they don't go away from him on this drive a little bit. He's been great, but they haven't scored a lot of points.
I think they still have to show him as a threat. Make sure he touches it a few times. But as you pointed out, use him as a decoy a little bit and get the ball in the hands of some other people in order to put more points on the board. But he's done a really nice job of establishing them with his running.
Yeah, he's established himself well. Now can they put more points up?
Here's second and 10. From the gun, here's Pickett. And his throw is incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
And the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10.
Working out of the gun, it's Pickett.
And a throw there going to be incomplete.
I think it's safe to say he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Force some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
On is the punter man as he boots this one away.
Here comes Carter. Called out a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Raiders will take over now, first and 10.
Here comes the offense again, and let's focus on Josh Jacobs for a moment.
It's the second quarter. His team has the lead, but I think he's hoping for a little bit more production out of himself.
And we often talk about preaching patience to a runner when things are a little bumpy in the early going, but we have to do the same thing with the offensive line. They can't wait to halftime to make the adjustments. They have to do it from series to series so they'll surface tap what's coming into play. Check out what the defense is doing and see if they can find a better way to run it.
So they search for that patience here now.
If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10.
And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
So they go pass, now they go run, and two plays resulting in really nice pickups.
Certainly sounds like a 50-50 deal, doesn't it? Sounds like great balance. Well, you know what all those coaches have told us over the years, Brandon, that balance is? It means doing what you want to when you want to. That play calling is working very well for them right now.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. On first down, Garoppolo.
Now into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Cole Holcomb. And the Steelers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Here comes the Pittsburgh Steelers and running back Najee Harris.
Now the ground game's been good, but they're losing here in the second quarter. Can they use that ground game maybe to work the air attack a little bit more?
I think so, because now you can throw play action off of being able to run the ball effectively. And oftentimes you might want to just swing your back out of the backfield, get the ball in his hands in open space, and just don't get to...
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Merrill.
And the return here will go to the 31-yard line.
Now their defense got him the football with an interception. They trot out there, Charles, in the very first play. They give the football right back.
Brandon, I almost expect you coming like an auctioneer. We've got two, we got two. Do I hear three? Remember, it was two in a row. Would we hit three in a row? Because these offenses, they got to be a little bit more careful as they go forward. These defenders, they're locked in and really focused.
Now a throw here to his running back.
That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground, and it's picked up by the Steelers. And this one will be brought back to the 22.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Kenny Pickett and the Steelers ready to work once again. He's been picked off twice in this ballgame already, and they'll try to sort things out here as they begin with a first down.
Harris starts the drive on the ground. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he takes it all the way down to the 32.
116 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half.
And when you draw up a draw play, you want to draw it up like that, right?
Sometimes it takes some fortitude to call that play, because if it doesn't work, it's a lot of angry people waiting in the hole for the runner. In this case, it broke free, a big gain.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. This is Harris on the draw. Give him maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime.
Second and 9. Here's Pickett. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
That is incomplete.
Thought a surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Boswell's kick is good, and they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10.
But trailing here in the first half still, but maybe, Charles, that'll help them get some momentum back. First the forced fumble, and then they're able to get a field goal out of it.
And down in the game, they came out and created their own opportunity on one side of the ball and did get points out of it, as you mentioned. Complimentary football right there as they try and bring this one back to even.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
The Raider offense heading back for one final first half drive.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. T.J. Watt in on the tackle. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, BG, thanks very much. And welcome one and all to our beautiful new downtown Orlando studios for this EA Sports Halftime Report. We just watched a solid first half of the 2022 rushing champ, Josh Jacobs. He wound up finding the end zone on a touchdown run to help give his guys the advantage here at the break. Both teams making their final adjustments before we get started once again. And for the call of the second half, let's send you back out to Allegiant Stadium and Brandon Gott.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Steelers going to get the football first here, trailing on the scoreboard as we are back underway on EA Sports. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The Steeler offense ready to get going to begin this third quarter. All in all, pretty manageable deficit, Charles, here as they start this third quarter offensively when you consider the fact that in the first two quarters, they had two costly turnovers.
I think you laid it out there perfectly, partner. Very tough to hold a lead going into the break if you continue to hand it over on multiple drives.
Yeah, and obviously, Charles, it would be very tough to climb back into the game if those turnovers continue.
I would say borderline impossible. You keep turning it over, I don't know how you make up a deficit.
Harris going to get it again on second down. 131 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
And that's the big fella's MO right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
Broken tackle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Another good run for him. What else is new? That'll put him right at 150 yards for the game, so he's really made his presence felt in this one.
On second down, this is Harris. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the three-yard gain brings up a third down. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. Yeah, brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue.
But it wasn't a goal line situation, but how about the goal line formation on third and short? They went in and went heavy. No surprise on who was going to get the football. How about the power exhibited there?
Yeah, that was just put a hat on a hat, drive forward. Nice job to pick it up. And a short gain down to about the 33. Robert Spillane, ex of the Steelers, is there on the stop.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And they move this all the way down to the 9. That one goes for 24 yards.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
A run with Harris out of the shotgun. They juked him. And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1 yard line. A good run, 8 yards there, and it'll be second and goal.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone. But now you've set yourself up for at least two, maybe three more shots from close range.
And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown.
Najee Harris punching it in from a yard away. And the Steelers have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half.
And how nice is it to have a guy like Najee Harris in the backfield when you get down near the goal line? He can use his 230-plus pound frame to just get you those tough yards, and he finishes things off here with a touchdown run.
Boswell good with the extra point, and it's now 17-14. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays.
And it was Najee Harris who finished it off with a touchdown run.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown.
And Carter deciding not to bring this one out.
So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half.
And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
Well, that's a defense coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Back to the air on second. It's Garoppolo. This throw to the middle, taken in by Cole. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Pressure comes, and the Steelers take him down. Larry Ogunjobi in for the sack. So the opening drive of this third quarter, they're trying to set the tone for the second half.
And without a doubt, they did exactly that. I've known coaches who have said the first 5 minutes of each half are so important to do exactly what you said, which is set the tone. I've also heard coaches talk about the first five plays. Let's go out and be aggressive right off the top. That's exactly what they did.
Here's A.J. Cole now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Call it an even 40-yard punt, 7, though, on the return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10.
Najee Harris and the Steeler offense set to go to work once again.
You see the numbers, all those carries. If you get that many carries in the drive, you better finish it with a touchdown. And he did.
Yeah, and deservedly so, right? Because we've seen times like the Carolina Panthers, sometimes Jonathan Stewart to carry the ball the way down, and then Cam, he's such a great goal line runner, he'll carry it in. But in this case, though, that didn't happen. The fellow lugging the load, he's the one who got to reap the reward.
Yeah, there was no touchdown vulture here.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Everybody, it's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter.
Again, it's Harris on second down. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry, and they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
Taking an awful chance of the football right there. You've got to lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances, putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the four-yard line. Here's Las Vegas ready to take the field. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Cameron Hayward getting upfield to make the stop.
Running the ball can be a struggle in this part of the field. In fact, it's a perfect spot for defenders to pin their ears back and try and work upfield, and they capture him for a loss.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. 48 yards on the ground for him so far. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in fourth down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Give him 7 yards on the play as they do pick up the third down conversion.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. Now they'll throw with Garoppolo. He hits Adams complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first.
Well, this offense hasn't been at their best here. They've made some mistakes. They've been frustrated. They've been largely shut down. But then you look up and say, wait a second. This is a one-score game. So they're still very much in this, and they're on the move here with a first down.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. To throw, it's Garoppolo. Got an open man, Keelan Cole. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
Well, this is where an offense needs to show what it's made of. And in fact, where a quarterback needs to show what he's made of, trying to engineer a fourth quarter comeback. And he hits a big one right there.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Garoppolo now. Over the middle, he's got Myers. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. They'll come up first and 10 here. Garoppolo again. It's caught, left side, Bolden. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
On play action, now Garoppolo. On a bad time late for a poor throw. It's intercepted. Levi Wallace with a pick. And the Steelers are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. So that, a definite deflator there on the interception.
Yeah, you work your way down the field thinking you're in position for a go-ahead score. But all it takes is one errant throw, and this one winds up a turnover.
Pittsburgh set to take over again on offense. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Another run on second down. Try to cover up. And he'll be taken down at the 18.
So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. 5 points of contact necessary at this stage as he'll run on first down. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. And he is going to have a Steeler first down. All smiles on that sideline. That should be the one to do it.
Well, you know me, partner. I never tell them to back off of being aggressive. But sometimes you see the consequences when you're overly aggressive and you don't secure tackles. Guys break through.
Trying to sell out to pry that football loose. And just as you said, cost some yardage.
Yeah, you got to go get him. Stand him up first before you go for the ball. Don't just go for it initially.
And the knee is taken for the Steelers out of the victory formation. Is gonna do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right? Just us against the world and get it done. How happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one.
Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half of the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say goodnight from Las Vegas.